Yes, ma'am, we can start. We are live.
Okay, thank you, Satish and Reema.
Ma'am, please start. We are live.
Is start or?
Yes, yes, you can start. We are live.
Okay, thank you. So very good afternoon to all of you. Myself Smita, working as scientist in Center for Marine Living Resources and Ecology and Attached Research Institute of the Ministry of Earth Sciences, located in Kochi. As all of you know, we actually Center for Marine Living Resources and Ecology, we address the research themes in regarding to the marine living resources component of the earth system studies. We do address the ecosystem dynamics, the marine biodiversity and its interactions with the environment, the changes in the diversity and the changes happening in the ecological interactions, etc., in regard to the anthropogenic effects and climate change impacts. So our studies are mainly linked to the or connected to the ocean resources, living resources, and the samples or source materials which we are using for the studies is based on ship-based observations. So we have to go in ships very regularly. Everything is based on the ship observations. We have to do trawling operations, other gears for plankton collections, chemical oceanographic parameters we need to collect, and physical oceanographic parameters. So this is in regarding to the means all the outputs coming out in this field is mainly based on these activities, which is again supplemented with the satellite and modeling efforts for a better representation and better outputs in the later stage. So while doing so, in regular connections, collections in the seas, one issue we have noticed is the plastics or debris which are floating in the oceans. Very commonly, sometimes we can see a very bad situation, the turtles and other life like mammals, etc., are floating in, are entangled in the nets and some attachments of the life in the bottom, in the plastics and other human waste or human dumped or materials. So this is a peculiar scene which is devastating, and we were not doing, especially in India, we know we were not, we haven't addressed this issue very extensively so far, or we are not taken this issue seriously. So this presentation, actually, this is a compilation of the status of the marine litters or marine pollution in the global scenario, and some case studies or which some observations we encountered, not only by us in the nearby institutes like fishery institutes, CMFRA, etc. And these observations I have compiled, and other actually what we can do in this aspect. And the main thing is it's a reduction, actually reduce of this plastic in the oceans or marine litters can only be done in the source. So we have to make awareness program, very strong awareness program amongst us. So we have done some attempts for this, and this all these slides actually I will take into that. So the topic or title given to my presentation is Litters in the Marine Systems, Pathways, Hotspots, and Ecosystem Impacts. So the background is, like plastic was not an issue before. The first major report or main report was by NOAA in 1998, on the Great Pacific Garbage Patch in the Pacific Trash Vortex, where the litter was estimated 4 numbers per cubic meter. It was very low compared to the situation we are facing now. And the next information or background information in this is 275 million metric ton of plastic waste is generated in 192 coastal countries in 2010, with 4.8 to 12.7 million metric ton entering the ocean. So this is a devastating estimate, and this is a really alarming situation. And when we see the statistics or estimates, the global production of plastic increased from 1.5 million tons in 1952 to 335 million tons in 2016, with an annual increase of 8.7. And in this proportion annually, our oceans are amassing about 8 million kilograms of plastic. The marine litter, it is known as marine debris. It's a human-created waste. And now our garbage dumps are overflowing with plastic, metal, and glass. It's a serious global concern. And because the plastic are cheap, durable, and easily produced, that has deliberately and accidentally been released in lake, sea, rivers, or any waterway. So it is being very largely dumped to the ocean. And when we estimate that, or we predict that if this situation goes like this, the amount of plastic in 2050 will be more than the fishes in the ocean. As per the estimates in 2004, we have the records that plastic in the ocean is 150 million metric ton, whereas in the global ocean, the fish in the ocean is 812 million metric tons. And if it goes in this way of activities in polluting the plastic, or without an awareness, if you are going like this without proper management of the plastics, it will be more plastics in the ocean than the fish by 2050. And when we see the materials in the marine litters, 80% are from the land-based activities, and 20% only is from the sea-based activities. Sea-based in the sense, it is from cargo and passenger vessels, and it is of all sizes, commercial and recreational fishing vessels, and offshore oil and gas rig platforms debris. And from the land-based activities, the sources are mainly, as all of us know, land runoff, littered rivers, rainwater, sewage, airborne particles, industrial waste, which are purely poorly landfill sites, and careless disposals of waste. These all are contributing to this marine litters. The hotspots, most of the cases are cities, harbors, and the industrial areas. Then river-based barmots, there are huge amount of depositions. Then sea-based accumulations also. And when we see the components, and what are the components in this pollution debris, actually, before that, actually, I would like to know, this is an emerging field of activity, and the methodology or protocol or the protocol or the sampling criteria for this field activity, research activity, is not finalized, or it is not uniform for the entire phase of the world. So one of the important classification for the size of the plastic is macro, meso, micro, and mini macro according to the size of the plastic. So macro in the sense greater than 25 millimeter sized materials, meso in the sense less than 25 to 5 millimeter, micro in the sense 0.5 to 1 millimeter, and mini micro in the range of 1 millimeter to 1 micrometer. So when we see the IUCN reports on primary plastics in the oceans, which is published in 2017, the contribution of the synthetic textiles is coming to the maximum, which is 28% of the microplastics in the ocean. Then comes the tires and rubber materials, that is 35% and tires and all is coming to 28%. And the city dust, etc., comes to 24 due to the runoff, etc. And the marine paints and markings, ship markings, etc., contribute 77%. Then the personal care, actually on board in the ships, actually in the passenger ships and in all the vessels, actually we are using extensively personal care products, shampoo, face wash and all. And the reason why we are with the crystals, mini microplastic materials. So these all are actually polluting the ocean, and it is in very badly affecting the marine life. So when the plastic reaches the ocean, what will happen? We have seen that 80% of the plastic is from land through runoff and from the coastal discharge and all, and 20% is from the ship. So the small plastics actually that may sometimes attach to the marine organisms, small organisms, planktons and all, and some there can be many seen in many as in the forms of attachments. So the currents of waves will take the plastics and these materials away from the coast, and in this as per the estimate, less than 1% of the total plastic floats in the surface, and the rest actually it will sink down according to the size and density and the weight of the particle or weight of the material. And due to the continuous wave action, UV light in the high tropics and all, and temperature, bacterial degradation and other mechanical actions, there will be degradation in this plastic to form the microplastics, and especially for the synthetic fibers and all. So this will sometimes unknowingly thinking that it is a food material, the fishes or small organisms which engulf as along with the food. So it will be in the gut for long, and it will be harmful for the digestive system. And when we see the global status, this is a statistics or estimates for the 2010 from the top 20 countries, which is categorized as economically, that highly economically safe countries or low income countries like that. And when we see the and according to the coastal population, they have categorized that. This is a study from Jampack et al. 2015, published in Science. And it is delivering that India is in the 12th position with disposing marine debris of the range 0.09 to 0.24. MMT per million metric ton per year. And the first one is China, second goes to Indonesia, Philippines, and the last, the 20th position in this list is United States. We can see the range in this, how the contribution is from the different countries. Now, when we see the rivers, top 20 polluting rivers, actually Asia contributes more in this way. Actually, our Ganges, which is flowing through India and Bangladesh, is contributing more and is in the second place. Again, China River Yangtze is in the first level for contributing more pollution. So this brings out some alarming situation that we are in a this is very carelessly we are doing, and we are not taking it this issue very seriously. Also, we are not seeing how impacted the this pollution is for the marine life, and how again it is turning to our own place. We are consuming the fish in a very large amount. So it is in effect very much harmful to the human health also. And another important thing, as I have mentioned, NOAA reported the first report in 1988 in the Pacific as the Pacific garbage patch. We know in the oceans there are cyclonic and anticyclonic gyres in the North Pacific and the South Pacific. So all the plastics are taken along with the currents and are formed as giant ocean patches. And this is the bottom picture is, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Actually, this is a very accumulated, thick concentrated patch. And it is seen that 73% of these litters are of plastics. So this is another, from a model effort again. Actually, this Great Pacific Garbage Patch itself is in three different small patches. One is Western Garbage Patch associated with the Kuroshio current system, and they now in the North Pacific subtropical current convergence zones, zone is having another patch, and in the California or North Pacific Pacific subtropical high is having Eastern Garbage Patch. So all this in total contribute 1,760,000 kilometers square of garbage patch. And this is applicable to other oceans also, other gyre system, especially South Pacific gyre. We can see the blue dot, and South Atlantic gyre also there is a patch, not that seen in Pacific. And in the Southern Ocean, in the Indian Ocean, we have the associated with the Indian Ocean gyre, we have a patch, and the North Atlantic gyre also. But these are all not that much intense or wide in comparison with the Pacific. And what are the particles or what are the elements in this litters? When we see this is an input from the massive volunteer activity. Over 5 lakh volunteers actively participated in an international coastal cleanup program. And this is an outcome of this. We can see the dot size is decreasing according to the number proportions. So cigarette butts, it is coming to around 18,63,838. Likewise, we have the straws and stirrers for not 9087, glass beverage bottles, other plastic bags, etc., etc. And the down below, it is another estimate in 1997, again from a massive cleanup activity of 340,000 people. And see the difference. Actually, cigarette butts, there are not much difference, only 3 lakh around. But the plastic beverage bottles, it has increased from 2,63,000 to 15,78,000 in this from 1997 to 2014. So 2017, and there is again tremendous increase in the straws they got. So what this indicate is that our lifestyle changing lifestyle is with the change in the lifestyle we are making more harm to the oceans. So this is this is published in IUCN 2017 reports. Now, when we go to the management practices and the management status of this plastic, when we see the mismanagement of plastics waste in the global scenario, we can see China is the worst in managing the plastic. greater than 5 million metric ton of plastic is discharging to the sea without proper management, and Canada less than 0.01, it is doing quite well in this regard, and India is in the second position, second group, 1 to 5 million metric ton. So this is the global status, and this also is from the studies from Jambek et al. 2015, and the countries which they have been considered for the studies are marked here as white. So this is the contamination extent in the world oceans. Again, this is with regard to the size of the plastic. The first one, that is, I have mentioned earlier also, it is the size classification or the methodology or the sampling protocol, it's not uniform. So for this particular study, they have adopted the size ranges 0.33 to 1 millimeter. And we can see how extensively the distribution is, especially in the Arabian Sea, the microplastics are very, very much abundant and the concentration is very thick. And when we, as size decreases, the distribution, we can see the changes in the color pattern, especially for the plastics or size greater than 200 meter. Though the distribution area is almost the same, as we said, it is mostly according to the current pattern and ship traffic routes, etc., etc. So this is what the condition in the global scenario, in the global oceans. So from the global status to our backyard, in India, we haven't taken up any major studies except that from MOES, from the NCCR and NIOT. It is like along the coast, this is from this map, particularly shown here is from a report of CMFRA Kochi. And here it was a volunteer activity in regard to the means cleaning, extent of cleaning along the beaches of the Indian coast. You can see many of the places are unsampled, and many are like, especially Ratnagiri and all is marked as clean. The most polluted places are Porbandar, then East Coast along the Vishakhapatnam area. And especially along Kerala coast and all, it is recorded as normal. But in the report itself, it says like the resolution of the survey, it has to be more so that only, then only we will get a clear picture on how extensively the pollution is along our beaches. Then other incidents, small observations, not small actually, which we came across and reported by CMFRA is that they have identified or encountered with the presence of fluorescent blue and green microplastic particles and fibers in two species of bivalves during the analysis. Also, we know anchovies and the oil sardines are very much consumed in our coastal areas, and these two are two of the favorite food for the Indian coastal community. And these fishes are also being identified with the fibers or plastic strands in the stomach. So this is actually coming back to us, what we are thrown or giving to the ocean very carelessly and without any second thought, we are doing polluting our oceans, and it is coming back to us again. So small activities from the NGOs and the local centers of fisheries, CMFRA and all. When during a survey, actually, along the two, three landing centers along the Kerala coast, like Bepur, Chambala, and Pudiyappa, they have seen that the average value of 2,068.72 gram of plastic is being collected from the Pudiyappa coast. Sorry, from the Bepur coast, and from Pudiyappa it is 732 gram, and from Chambala it's about 625 gram. And the continuous survey shows that there is a trend from July to December. There will be more amount of plastic they were getting, and during November it is getting big. The reasons actually still we don't know. We need to explore on that. These are the photographs of the microplastic fibers standard in the strands which they got. Again, this slides are from Dr. Kripa Siamafare. So these are photographs from the strand, on the strands, microplastic strands in the sardines and the gut content. We can see huge plastic materials in the guts of the organisms. And again, on the plastic strand in the gut of mackerel, this is reported in 2010. Then benthic fauna, especially the worms, like bottom living worm, the polychaetes, they are stranded with the or entangled with nylon strands. Actually, these are the few observations which we came across while sampling and while doing the analysis in the laboratories and all. And one of the other, actually, apart from the so far discussed plastic contaminations and all, another alarming threat is the disposal of ghost nets in the sea. Ghost nets in the sense, the nets discarded by the fishermen, which cannot be used further for as it is damaged. So it is told that once if it is disposed in the sea, it is goes for the fish. Actually, ghost fishing they are doing. So there is a definition on this, like ALDFG, abandoned, lost, or otherwise discarded fishing gear. This actually we can see floating all over the oceans when we go for our scientific cruises. Sometimes entangled with the whales or sometimes with the turtles. We could see, even could see some turtles dead entangled in this. Some of them we could save. But it's like sometimes we also will be helpless in doing anything. So this is a major alarming situation, especially in the coastal fishing area. So we have discussed this with the officials also along the coastal states, and the fishermen also, when we interacted, we have mentioned this with the fishermen also. They told like there is what we will do after taking back to the coast. There is no proper garbage processing mechanism, or if we kept it there also, after sometimes it will be a problem in that area. There will be huge accumulation of such nets, especially in the harbors and all. So it is happening like that. But actually, there are few steps taking up positively. They have started in a few parts of the coastal area, starting garbage disposal and processing for the recycling plants and all. So we have some positive steps also. We could see some positive also steps also taking up in this regard. Now again to the fishes, actually this is eggs of gastropods and octopus and fishes. Actually, this is extensively being impacted by the microplastics and plastic strands. It is very clear in the picture itself. This is also from CMFRA. And this is a paper published in Science, actually, in the European waters. They have identified that the microplastic content or contamination due to the these plastics in the area is affecting the growth rate, and the actually they inhibit hatching. The hatching of the eggs are being inhibited by the presence of these microplastics, and the food preference is also being altered. This is an example shown in the European purchase. So the thing is that this type of situations are or changes happening in this ecological functioning is becoming a reason for a reduced success in the recruitment of the fishery. So fishery is being reduced in particular areas exclusively due to this reasons. So the impact is wide, even in the smaller organisms in the early life stages itself, it has been seems to be affecting. And this is not only in the coastal areas or in the surface or column area, in the deep bottom also, in the dark deep bottom, the middle photo is deep ocean of depth 1300. There are huge number of plastics we could see. This is a survey in the photographs from the survey in the Mediterranean Sea along France. We can see large number of plastic bottles and plastic unused means equipments or instruments. We are not sure what it is, and some ropes and plastic carriage bags, etc. That was the situation in France, and this is right from the Indian waters, just near in the background of backyard of Kerala. We have a terrace area. We call it as terrace of Trivandrum. It is almost 200 kilometers away from the coast, and 1,200 to 1,500 deep area, and we do extensive surveys or bottom trawling for the fishes, deep demersal fishes for the area, because that's a unique system with large biodiversity and all. And every time, actually, we were doing it extensively during 2012 to 2017, and every time when we do fishing operations there, we used to get any kind of these materials. Every trawls, it is it will be seen with any of these materials. Like we can see some of the in the photo mark the air, the sea anemone attached to the PVC pipe, and oil drums, bottles, garbage bags. Actually, it is tied and just dumped into the ocean. That's what it is shown. And banana palm, green grass. Actually, I'm stressing green grass. And clothes and toothpaste, coconut husk and plastic bags. Actually, when we see the green grass and the degree of degradation happen to the coconut husk, and the toothpaste, actually, when we saw the manufacturing date, it was not that much old. It was recent make. So, and this we got from 1,200 meter depth area, depth zone. So it is so that they, it is quickly, very quickly transported to the this part of the ocean. And they actually, I mean, the physical processes, the current pattern in the area, everything actually is contributing such a means to create such dumping yards. Or actually, we have to be very clear, very careful in the coastal sites, especially to avoid such situations. That's what you know. That's what it is indicated here from the samples we are getting. And we know, as per the Sustainable Development Goals of the UN, 14 refers to the life below the water. And according to the clause 14.1, by 2025, we need to prevent and significantly reduce marine pollution of all its kind. So prevent marine pollution of all its kinds, in the sense the first most devastating thing is marine litters or marine plastics. And we feel like we have to take up more effort to address this area. We have to address this area for the mitigation process and for the to reduce this effect and to protect our ocean for a sustainable usage of its resources. We need to understand the potential area, we need to understand the status of this pollution very in a detailed manner. So some of the area, actually I have mentioned, we have in India, NCCR and NIOT has come up with very good projects or plans for the activities, and they have been doing it. And as of now, actually we need to put more effort on in identifying the hotspots. Actually, we have seen the whales or the eddies or guys. They in these places actually have an in these areas the patches are being accumulated, and such hotspots, if we identify, it would be more effective in addressing this situation. That is one way of suggestion from this compilation of information. And all the information actually from all the ships of research hubs, and we need to all the biological samples or information from the all the biological analysis, etc., to be compiled for this information, this type of information, and a synthesis of estuarine, coastal and deep sea systems is needed in this regard. And of course the pathways that are very important, because so it's a pathways of marine debris based on its characteristics that can be well monitored with the current sites and physical processes. And we have to identify the marine hotspots for the effective mitigation processes and the impact on the ecosystem elements, especially in the organisms from primary to secondary, and in all the levels like meso, macro and mega levels. We have to clearly understood on this aspect, and all this to be given as input for the management and mitigation processes. So in this one of the main aspect, actually, rather than actually we have the status now in our hand, what is the global status. And in Indian waters also we have to strengthen our information. And the other aspect of this marine litters is to stop it from the, or to reduce the effect from its source. So for that we need extensive awareness program, especially not only in the coastal community, but for the entire human or entire activity which we are dealing with. So in 2019, we have been doing a survey for the ecosystem processes along the coastal waters of the west coast of India. From our research plan was to take the survey from Oka to Kochi, and the period being tallying with the Swachhata Week, we have planned, we have accounted one more activity as an awareness program in this scientific voyage. And while starting, just before to means before starting from Oka, we have conducted awareness in the schools, nearby schools in the area. We have interacted with the stakeholders, district magisters, and we have told them the impact, how extensive it is, how dangerous it is. We made them to understand how it is. So after that, we have done some beach cleaning activity also in that area. Then another stop we made for the vessel at Oka, as seen in the yellow markings here. There also we have interacted with the public, school, college, children and stakeholders. And the ship was then stopped at Karwa region, again the process continued, and then finally we have completed this campaign in Cochin on 2nd October, and more than 2000 students and stakeholders and higher officials in government representatives all visited the vessel, and we have been giving them details on the, actually the students very well explored the scientific facilities on board. They were very enthusiastic, and our scientists, those who were in the team during that cruise, interacted, and they have delivered lectures for the students for the on the activities, and we have showed them the videos on the impact of plastic, actually what all we encountered during our voyages. So, and we have given them awareness on the to reduce the usage of plastic, and we have been given with them some gifts on steel bottles and all, as normally we do here also. And it was very interesting to get the response from the students, because they are the next generation to keep the earth clean and fragile. And also we have conducted a satellite seminar in CMLRE on the Sustainable Development Goals 14, especially with the theme on marine litters, and there were invited lectures from eminent scientists and groupers, and these are the press coverages during that time, just for the information, and the beach cleaning activities which we had done during the course of action. And actually, as part of the awareness program, actually in many part of the world there were art installations were doing, and this is from the dumped plastics in a coastal area. This is available in YouTube, so I have just taken it too. And this is just in our backyard, Fort Kochi, in the during the Christmas and New Year Eve, they have during that time they have created it 4000 square feet size mat crab installation with the discard plastics. So our what we are going to deliver is we have to take this issue seriously, very seriously. We have to understand the situation very clearly and thoroughly. And towards the mitigation process, we have to extend the scientific activities to understand how the impact is on the ecosystem in each component. What are the innovative ideas we can implement to reduce this impact in the organisms? And the main message we are giving and given earlier also, actually it is the 3 R's, as all we know: replace, reuse and reduce. And we have to properly maintain our ocean. We have to keep it clean, not only ocean, the earth. And as it is like, be the change you wish to see in the world. Actually we are working towards clean ocean. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Smitha, for a very nice informative talk on marine plastics. There were a few questions. I will post it through the chat window. Please read the questions and answer.
Okay. The question one I could see is there more plastic litter in rivers or is it in ocean? I don't know. I think we cannot answer for this. It is, of course, it is coming from the rivers. And in the coastal area or in the backwaters and all, when the survey says the amount of plastic is very huge. And in the oceans, coastal oceans, we don't have an estimate how much the plastic is in a particular area or not. So as I mentioned, we have to do extensive survey and more estimates to be done on this aspect. I don't think right now we can give an answer for this. The another question is India taking any prevention measurements to restrict marine plastic pollution? If so, how? Yeah, India actually activities are there in smaller scale. Like when we did our campaign or awareness program along the west coast on board Sampada, as I mentioned, we had interacted with the district magistrate and all, and they have told that already there is a mechanism for collecting the ghost nets and the garbage which are taken away by the fishermen from the ocean. So one problem faced by the fishermen earlier was that there was no processing mechanism. So the actually last year they have mentioned that last year they have started the plan, started implementing the processing units of Karnataka state along the coast of Karnataka. So that is there. And along the Kerala coast also, there are so many NGOs working for cleaning the ocean coastal area. And in the beaches, some cleaning activity, we could see some trawlers, like filtering trawlers is being used to clean up the beaches, especially in the Visakhapatnam area and all. That's what the information we do have right now. Other question is, are there any reports of death in India or world over due to entry of plastic in humans from consumption of fish? In my knowledge, it is not there. Anyway, we need to have a detailed check on that. Other question is, in the Swachh Bharat initiation as well as cleaning up Indian major rivers, how impactful it is in cutting down the inflow of plastics from rivers to oceans in India? Yes, actually, this is a very good movement for cleaning the rivers and all. To reduce the plastic pollution in the river banks and all, and in the rivers, major rivers. But another thing we have to do along with this is we have to have a clear mechanism for the proper management of this waste or processing of this plastic or debris in the source, or we have to have a decentralized mechanism, at least in the panchayat level or something like that. In the local government level, we need to have the supporting system so that the processing system, so that it will not reach to the rivers and then to the ocean. I think we know it is over.
Yes, Smita, you have answered all the questions. And, thank you for sharing your time with our webinar. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Vinu. Thank you, and Vinu and Satish and the MOES and CMLRE director. Thank you all for this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you. Satish, we can go offline now. Thank you.